Howdy folks, Mobile Tech here. And today, I'm going back to work after being off for a month. It all started with a fishing trip that I was supposed to go on. And I drove 425 miles up into the mountains and the Sierras and stuff, and it was 101 degrees up there. And it was crowded, there was too many people, too many ATVs in the campgrounds, too many unruly children, and including the adults, they seemed to be unruly also. And I went, you know, this is just not what I signed up for, so I came back, but it was too hot to work, that's why I was going on vacation. I usually take part of July and the whole month of August off. Well, it's late August, and I've been off all this time, doing nothing. I got sick for 3 weeks. So I'm finally at the tail end of being sick and I'm bored, so I want to go back to work. I'm going to go on another fishing trip here in a few weeks, but I want to get some work done. So that's what we're going to do. Give you an update on where I'm at on the 66 Shasta, the Super Shasta. Been putting the paneling in. And it's looking really well, really good. I love this paneling. It's looking really good. So I'm pretty happy with it. Got some touch-up work to do. I've got to sand all the tops down flush with the framing. I make it a little big just because it's better to be too big than too small. And nothing's square in a trailer or flat or level or plumb or anything. So you got to make everything a little bit big and then sand it down. If you want to do perfect work anywhere, anyway, which is what I like to do, as you know. So I've got it up to here inside the bathroom. And the next thing to do is to go ahead and install the shower wall that I had powder coated. And so I'm going to do that, and then we will be able to, let's see, there's no paneling that goes here on this plywood wall, it's just flush. That's how that works. And the paneling doesn't start again until the end of the door here. So I can get, after I get the walls sanded down and get the GIMP goes right on top here, all the way around, I can go ahead and put the first two top ceiling panels on here that go lay right into this channel. This is called a rabbet, R-A-B-B-E-T. And it's, as you can see what it looks like here, see? It's the same way that drawers are made. If you make a set of drawers, the back end of the drawers are rabbeted like this. Actually, the back end, the front. So that has to be there. I don't like the design. This was done by Shasta for production purposes. A lot of it done with machines. These walls are assembled and then tilted up. It's to make for easy installation of the ceiling. I don't really like it myself. I prefer the old method that the canned hams have, where this is not here. It's just flat down to here, and then you put your paneling all the way over and your framing all the way over, and then build it up with curbing. You've seen that in all my other videos. So this is something new to me because it's the newest trailer I've ever worked on. Well, the newest trailer I've ever rebuilt, anyway. I've worked on almost brand new trailers and motorhomes before, but as far as tearing one completely down, this is the newest. So I want to get the top on at least the first two panels, which will take me up to here with the GIMP and the ceiling and everything, and that way it will hold the walls together. I can take this out. This is just up there to hold the wall together right now so it doesn't fall over. And I can go ahead and button up the rear. And once I do that, I can move on and finish the paneling, interior paneling and the ceiling material all the way up to the front here. And I'll open up the front. Then the front will stay open. That's so that we can come back in and lay our new sheet material for our floor, our flooring. And then we can rebuild the cabinets that go here. And the dinette cabinets. And we can place those on top of the new flooring. Of course, I'll also rebuild this upper cabinet that goes up here. Stick that in. And it gets fastened through the ceiling down, just like here, all this cabinet gets fastened from the top. I gotta re-glue some of this. Didn't get held right. And then that's basically what holds the trailer all together is the cabinets. You know, if you gut a trailer, take all the cabinets out, you've removed all the structural integrity. That's all that holds it together, really. You have no sway strength or shear strength without the cabinets. So that's not something you want to do. We don't gut trailers, we gut fish. And you see what happens to a fish when you gut it. All right, so that's pretty much it. I just wanted to give you an update. I know you haven't heard much from me in the last month, and that's why. I've just been hunkering down and they're really not doing anything but being sick and being miserable in the heat. Couldn't work anyway, so if I was going to get sick, I guess that's the best time. I've never had a summertime cold before, and this one lasted 3 weeks. I'm still on the tail end of the cold, so I'm not completely over it. But that's where Mobile Tech's been, what he's been doing, and now we're going to get back to work on this trailer. So stay tuned, and happy trailering. We'll see you later.